If you take a look at this list of networks, we've got various things. We've got the MAC addresses, the SSIDs, the RSSI, or signal strength in DB, the channel that they're running, the vendor name, privacy, which is the type of security that they're running, the data rates, network type, and then a few other things like first seen, last seen, latitude and longitude, if we had GPS. If we take a look down here, we have a few different tabs. The first tab is news. This is basically kind of like a blog from the MetaGeek site, so it has a lot of stuff that's not really pertaining to what we're doing with wireless networks. Next, we have the time graph. And as you can see, we've got a lot of data in here. It's kind of just messed up with a ton of different things. So we're actually going to clear out some of this stuff so that we only have a few listings here. To do that, we go ahead and uncheck checkbox next to the listing in the top that we don't want. I'm going to hang on to this Netgear Managed and this Netgear. And we're going to go ahead and turn the rest of these guys off. Alright, so we've got all that closed out. We've got two history lines now. If you take a look at our history graph, we're covering about 4 minutes of time, and we've been covering just a little over a minute. If you take a look here, we've got the two access points listed with the colors of the graph that they're going to show. The Netgear Managed is going to show red, and our Netgear is going to show gray. And if you take a look here, we've got the measurement of signal strength in RSSI, basically the dB measurement of the signal strength, and that's going to show us that signal strength over time. This is really good for finding out if you have an AP that's having some power problems or issues where it's only putting out power for a small amount of time and then dropping signal. Next, we've got the channel graph. And the channel graph is pretty standard. We've got channels 1 through 13. In the United States, we only can use 1 through 11. And you'll notice that we have these strange squared off curves. Well, these squared off curves are actually the channel that the device is on. If you take a look here, this device is on channel 1 because that's the middle of the curve. And you'll notice that it actually overlaps into channel 3. And the same thing here on the Netgear side, we've got channel 11, and it's overlapping to 9 and 13. This is actually what we call channel overlap. And to kind of illustrate that, we'll go ahead and turn on C7 Wireless. And you'll notice that it actually overlaps our Netgear that's out here on channel 11. This overlap space will cause interference. It's going to cut down the data rate that you have available to you. It's also going to cut the signal strength. This is what we're trying to avoid by moving devices off of unobstructed channels. Take a look at the 5 GHz channel pane. It's the same thing. My device doesn't have a 5 GHz radio, so we don't show any data here. But if you take a look, we've got channels 36 through 64, which we use in the US, and then 149 through 165, which are also available in the United States. The 100 through 140 is not available here. If you take a look at this, this is the same rules basically here. You'd have, if we could see data, we'd see curves of data or of channels. And the same thing here, you want to avoid those overlaps as well. Next section we have is filters. You can filter anything that you see up here in this top table. A lot of people will use that to filter, for instance, on the channel, maybe the SSID, or the privacy type, and it will just list those specific items below. And the last section we have is GPS, and this works great also if you have a GPS radio, but once again, like I say, we don't have a GPS radio on this laptop, so unfortunately we can't show you that today. And that's Insider.